We continue now at the top of Daf Tazayinam and Beis Maseches Pesachim. This is Pesachim Daf 16b. The Gemara had tried to prove that that water, Mayim Tolushin, is not Machshir from the fact that the Mashka Beis Mitvachaya, the liquids that are on the floor of the Azara, they're not Machshir. So the Gemara said, no, that was not talking about water. That was actually talking about the blood. The halach is the blood is only Machshir if you allow it to spill on the floor like water. It's compared to water. But if it's something that has to be received in a kli, meaning dam kachim, it's not machshir, and that's a statement of Rabbi Yochanan. Gemara continues the statement over here: dam she'eino nishbach kamayim. When you have dam like dam kachim, which does not pour like water onto the ground, rather it is received in a kli because it has to be used on the mizbeach. Eino machshir. That's not machshir lekavil toma. Maskif lor of Shmuel bar Ami. So Rav Shmuel bar Ami asks: Hare dam hatamtzitz. What about the dam which is called dam hatamtzitz? Rashi will explain. The nishbach kamayim veino machshir. That is something we do not receive in a kli, and it's also not machshir. Rashi says, dam atamtzitz eino roy lizrika. That's dam that you don't use for zrika. You don't throw it on the mizbeach. You don't sprinkle it. Tichsiv ki adam hu banefesh yechaper. We darshan dam shahanefesh yotzabo. Blood which, when that blood comes out, the animal dies. Mechaper. That is a kapara. That's what we put on the mizbeach. V'she'ein hanefesh yotzabo. But if it is dam which does not cause the animal to die, eino mechaper. That's dam atamtzis. That dam is not going to be mechaper. Alma nishbach kamayim. You see that such water flows, such a blood flows like water. V'eino machshir. It's not machshir. Ked Rav Yossi Rav Chanina, like Rav Yossi Rav Chanina said. So it's a contradiction to what we just said. So the Gemara says, Amar le Rabbi Zeira. Rabbi Zeira said back to him, Hanoch l'dam atamtzis. Don't ask from dam atamtzis. De'afilu b'chul l'nami lo machshir. Because the truth of the matter is, it's not machshir at all anyway. Whether it's kachim or chulin, dam atamtzis is not the kind of blood that is machshir. Kibla minei Rav Shmuel Barami. Rav Shmuel Barami accepted this answer. How do we know that dam atamtzis is not machshir? De'omer achmona, because the pasuk says, Rak chazak levilti achol hadam. Ki adam hu hanefesh. It says the blood is the soul. Meaning, dam shanefesh yotzebo, blood which is the soul, which when that blood leaves, the soul leaves, karoi dam. That's called dam, and that can be machshir, that can prepare food to be makabel tumma. Dam she'ein hanefesh yotzebo, but dam hatamtzis, meaning blood that is not critical, it does not cause the person or the animal to die, eino karoi dam, that's not called dam, and that is not going to be machshir, lekabel tumah. Gemara now tries another proof against Rav. Again, Rav said that when it comes to liquids on a doraisa level, they're never tameh. So Toshma coming here, dam shenitma says beferish over here, blood that becomes tameh, vizarku, and then you sprinkle it on the mizbeach anyway. Beshogeg hurtza b'mezid lo hurtza. If you do it by mistake, it's going to be okay. If you do it on purpose, it's not going to be okay. So in any case, clearly you have a concept of dam shenitma. So the Gemara answers me, Drabbanan. No, the dam we're talking about here that's Tameh is only Tameh on a Drabbanan level. Udalok Rav Yossi ben Yoezer ish Treda. This particular Braisa doesn't follow Yossi ben Yoezer ish Treda. Again, Yossi ben Yoezer ish Treda said that since in general Mashkin is only Drabbanan, so then in the Beis Mitvachaya, if it's stuff that happens in the Azara, liquids from Kachim are not going to be Tameh at all. This does not agree with that. This holds that liquids can be Tameh on a Drabbanan level, and that extends even to Beis Mitvachaya. Even dam and other liquids that are part of the karbonos, part of the kachim, those are also going to have that tumah midrabbanan, not like Rav Yossi ben Yoezer ish Treda said on the previous amud. Tashma coming here, another proof against Rav. Al ma hatzitz meratza, what does the tzitz allow? What kind of tumah does the tzitz allow? Al hadam, v'al habasar, v'al hachelev, whether it be dam, basar, chelev, shenitma, that becomes tameh, bein v'shogeg, bein v'mezid, bein v'onas, bein v'ratzen, bein v'yachid, bein v'tzivor. Again, all of these situations, the tzitz is meratza, and it's going to be okay, even if it's done in tumah. Point being, clearly says that dam can become tameh. And again, the Gemara gives the same answer, midrabanan, we're just talking about tumah, derabanan, udalo, kerebi yosi, ben yoezer, ish treda. Again, not like Rav Yossi ben Yoezer ish Treda, because there is Tumah Derabbanan not only on regular Mashke, but even Beis Mitvachaya. Gemara tries another proof, Tashma coming here, V'nasa Aaron es Avon HaKadoshim. Aaron, again with the tzitz, will carry any sins that happen during the Karbanos. V'chi Eza Avon, who knows, say, what sins are we talking about? Im Avon Pigol, if we're talking about Pigol, Harei Kvar Nemar Lo Yeratza, that means you have a Machshava, that you're doing it outside of the proper place. It already said that's not acceptable. Imavo noser, if it's a machshava, you have to do it in not the proper time. Harek varnemar lo yechoshev, again, not acceptable. So what kind of sin is being accepted by kachim? Ha'eno nosei ala avon tumah. Obviously, we're talking about the sin of tumah. Shehutra michlala b'tzibur, because tumah already is something that if you have a tzibur, you can bring karbanos b'tumah. And so here you have a situation of tumah, and the Gemara says, ma'ilav tumas dam. What kind of blood? What are you putting on the mizbeach that is in tumah? That's okay. Seems to be blood. And again, you see that the liquids can become tumah. So the Gemara says to that, Amar Rapapa, Rapapa says, lo tumas kamatzim. We're not talking about blood. We're talking about the komets. The komets of the mincha, which is the fistful of flour that you take, is the equivalent of dam by an animal. You take this komets, you put it on the mizbeach, just like you sprinkle blood on the mizbeach, and that allows for the carbon to now be eaten by the kohanim. So we're not talking about dam over here. In this particular brisa, we might be talking about komets, and we're saying that Aaron HaKohen carries the sin of tumah when it comes to the komets, but when it comes to blood, maybe, blood is never going to be tameh. Gemara tries another proof, Tashma, come in here. Hein yiso ish b'sar kodesh b'chnaf bigdo v'naga b'chnafo el alechem v'el anzid v'el ayayin v'el shemen v'el kamaychol hayi kodesh. So this is talking, this is a pasuk in Chagai, where he's asking, is this particular case, we'll see in Rashi, but is this yikodesh, is it tamei? V'yanu ha-kohanim v'yomru lo. So the kohanim answer, and they say, no, it's not tamei. Point of the proof obviously is that we're talking about liquids becoming tamei. Rashi over here explains, Sar kodesh, sheretz lashon kodesh haya ba'aretz tumah, we're talking about tumah of sheretz. V'yachagai hanavi bodek as ha-kohanim. What's happening over here is Chagai is testing the kohanim. B'shnashtayim l'daryavish, it's the second year of Daryavish, shahoye b'vinyan bayis sheni, it's during the building of the second Beis HaMikdash, leida in b'kiyin b'hilchas tumah. He wants to check, do the kohanim know the halachas of tumah? They forgot the halachas in exile when they weren't dealing with kachim. So he asks the following question. You have it, it touches the actual sheretz. We're obviously talking about touching the sheretz directly, not talking about the corner of the garment, because the whole beged would then be a rishon. Why talk about the corner? The whole beged's that way. So Chagai's question was like this. The sheretz touched some bread. Lechem touched nozid, nozid touched yayin, yayin touched shemen. Ol kol machol, or anything else. It touched either the shemen or something else. Hayikadish, is it going to be tameh? Meaning, klum nitmo ha'acharon hazeh. The last thing in the list, he was asking them, is it tameh? Shehu revi bakodesh. It's basically a revi. The lechem rishon, the lechem is a rishon. Unezid sheni, the nezid is the sheni. V'yayin shlishi, the yayin is shlishi. V'shemen revi. So he was asking them, is there revi bakodesh? That's basically Chagai's question. And so they answered no. And we'll continue with this discussion in the next video on Daf Yud Zayin Amud Aleph.